Good thing. All right. Thank you very much, Ainsley. Mainstream media screaming Russia, Russia, Russia after the president told reporters while flying to Vietnam that he talked to Vladimir Putin about Russian meddling in our election. Putin denied it. But that's not how the media reported it.
I think he's giving Putin a pass, and I think it demonstrates to Mr. Putin that Donald Trump can be played.
He believes him, while he does not believe the intelligence agencies of the United States of America.
Donald Trump's policy seems to be trust. Hey, listen, Putin said that they didn't do it, so they didn't do it.
So were the president's remarks taken out of context? Some think so. So here we've got a debate right now. We've got staff writer for The Federalist, Bree Payton, along with professor and liberal political commentator, Wendy Asefo. Ladies, good morning to both of you.
Good morning.
Professor, let's start with you. Some analysts said that it sounded like he was siding with Vladimir Putin over his own intel agencies, although that wasn't quite what the president said. What do you make of that?
Well, I think it's really interesting that he mentioned the names of Comey and Clapper, and he said that they were political hacks. Mm-hmm. And that's not something we want to say, especially when we're dealing with a foreign adversary like Russia. And quite frankly, you know, I don't think that there is a media bias. In a recent study from Harvard, they actually showed that there is not a media bias towards Trump. It's just the way in which the media is portrayed. The media likes things that are fun, that are disorganized, that, you know, are a little off left field. And with the Trump administration, he's had a bunch of missteps. So as they're reporting, they're not reporting this to say he's a bad president. They're just targeting the things in which he's done that is out of the ordinary.
All right. Bree, what do you think? Our own John Roberts reported that the president never said he believes Putin, and yet the mainstream media coverage was, I saw several examples of where they were saying, well, the president believes President Putin over his own intel agencies. That's not at all what he said.
Yeah, it really isn't at all what he said. I mean, in the next breath, he said, I believe our intelligence agencies, they're very fine people that work over there. So, I mean, I think he's making a distinction that Putin's not going to change his answer. And, you know, we're just going to have to move on from there, right? We're going to have to trust our own intelligence community, trust our intelligence agents and move on and go from there. And I think, you know, if the reason why all of this matters so much is because there is an ongoing investigation into whether or not the Donald Trump campaign and to what extent they colluded with Russia in order to meddle in the election, right? So it matters. It matters to be accurate and it matters to be precise. And being imprecise and sloppy and acting like Donald Trump and Putin are best friends honestly just plays into the Kremlin's hand. And this is really what Moscow wants, to seem more powerful and more influential and to make Donald Trump seem like he's this dumb buffoon. That's just totally playing into the Kremlin's hand, right? I mean, we have to zoom out and look at the long game here. So it's very important
to be correct and
precise.
And perhaps, Bree, that's why a number of outlets today are showing that awkward photo of the president going like trying to shake hands like that. When you look at the tape, it wasn't that awkward at all. Professor, what do you think about this?
I honestly think that, you know, Bree makes some good points, but we can't try to dumb this down and say that there was no collusion. You know, we have some evidence that says that something happened. We don't know we don't know whether, in fact, the collusion happened between the Trump administration and Russia, but I do believe we have to let the investigation play out. And again, this is not something where he can say in one breath, I believe the evidence from my intel committee, and in the same breath, call the members of that committee, you know, political hacks. We're not, you know, the American people are very smart
right
here. We understand the game that is being played. And so if he does believe the evidence that's coming out of his intel committee, then he needs to say that. He doesn't need to then go into the name calling, which he's not only done to members of the intel committee, he's also done to the media. He's called them dumb. He's called them reckless. He said all types of things that are nefarious and is not becoming of the holder of the highest office in the land.
All right, Bree, we'll give you the final word.
Yeah, you know, Wendy, I completely agree with you that we do need to let this investigation play out. And it is very important to get to the bottom of it and determine whether or not the Trump campaign did indeed collude with Russia to meddle in the election. We know that Russia did try to meddle with our election and try to play with our minds, play this propaganda long game. And I think you're right. It is very important. But I also think that those two things can be true and don't conflict with one another, right? I think it's possible to trust the intelligence community's analysis about Russia meddling
right
in the election. election. And it's also factually true that James Comey is a hack, right? I mean, his behavior has demonstrated that to be true over and over again.
And the president was referring to that report that was compiled by Comey and Clapper and Brennan, and that's why he referred to them as political hacks. All right, ladies, great discussion this morning.
Thank you, Wendy Asefo,
professor, and Bree Payton from The Federalist. All right, good. All right, coming up.